Sujanar Budaradito Pado Jugam Jugadhar Madurandara Patrupadam Baradhava Yodayo Kapuya Padam Pranamami Sada Prabhupada Padam. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told that I can show inclination unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava. I can show my inclination, my submission unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava. Up to that point, if my personal interest is disturbed, then I reject my Gurudev, then I dismiss my Gurudev. This is the point. This is our submission. This is our inclination. Actually, today is the disappearance day of Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada. We say Viraha Mahatsav. How is that possible that Prabhupada going away from us, but we say this big Mahatsav? How is that possible? Whereas we see in material world, when somebody taking birth, some baby, we are very happy. When that man dies, we become very sorry. But here, how is that possible that when Vaishnav appear, we are very happy, we are celebrating that day, and when Vaishnav disappears, still we are speaking is Mahatsav, Maha Mahatsav. Actually, point is that it is all the same. When Vaishnav appears and when disappears, it is all same, because Vaishnav coming from transcendental world, Krishna sending, and disappearance means actually he is going out of my sight, material sight. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada someday speaking, today is the disappearance day of my Gurupad Padma, but I feel today is the appearance day of my Gurupad Padma, because I find my Gurupad Padma here in my heart continuously. So it is appearance day for my Guru Maharaj. So to find this point, you see, when appearance day, then we feel actually it is a question of Vipralamba. When we celebrate appearance day, when Gurupad Padma, we can lose our Gurupad Padma, so we feel separation. This way we are thinking, actually one circle is there, one point, you see, if you find one point there, and you know, then you can see starting and end. One circle, a circumference, starting point is same with originating point, same. So for Vaishnav, we are celebrating this day, disappearance day, Maha Mahatsav, because Prabhupada going back to his, you know, Nitya Seva, here also doing Nitya Seva. So we are happy. Now actually point is there. Prabhupada, what for Prabhupada came? That is the main question. Kipaya hari kirtana murti dharam dharani varaharaka gaura janam janakadika vasa lasnigda padam pranamami sada prabhupadu padam. Kipaya hari kirtana murti dharam param pujabhat Srila Sridhar Goswami Maharaj writing, Kipaya hari kirtana murti dharan. When Harikatha Harikirtan took the form of Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, we couldn't understand him. Main point. Actually, Harikirtan can take the form of Gurupad Padma, Harikirtan can take the form of Prabhupada. It is called VaniSwarup. Actually, it is called VaniSwarup. Until and unless you cannot understand this VaniSwarup or Gurupad Padma, staying with Gurupad Padma or Vaishnava is all useless. You are staying with Gurupad Padma for a long time, 20 years or 50 years maybe, but it is useless if you cannot understand the VaniSwarup or Gurupad Padma. Then your staying is useless actually. To stay with Gurupad Padma, to stay with Vaishnava, is to stay with his Siddhanta, Vichar, this is called Vaishnava association. Association is most important thing. Without association, you cannot build up your life. So Prabhupada came to give us his holy association, but I am so full, I cannot understand. I couldn't understand actually. Point is that. In Siva Sangan, you see, Siva Sangan, it is called Nitya Rasasthali. It is called Nitya Rasasthali Siva Sangan. There, actually Chaitanya Mahaprabhu started Sankirtam Jagyagni. Actually, Siva Sangan, it is the place where Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu started his Sankirtan Yajna, the Siva Sangan. That fire is still going on, still that fire is there. Prabhupada speaking, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu enlightened the fire of Sankirtan Yajna Agni, and we Gaudiyas, if we have the right to identify ourselves as a Gaudiya devotee, we all should sacrifice our life unto the lotus feet of Gurupad Padma. We can throw ourselves into this fire of Sankirtan Jagyagni. We must also do Sankirtan from heart. This is the identity of Gaudiya Vaishnavas. Those who are ready to sacrifice their lair, sacrifice their life for Sankirtan Yajna, for Sankirtan Yajna, they are actually Gaudiya devotees, they are actually dear and near one of Gurupad Padma. Now for preaching, to preach that transcendental, Siddhanta, Vani, Prabhupada came here, but Prabhupada speaking, preaching can be done both way. One is negative way, another is positive way. Preaching can be done both way. One is negative way, another is positive way. Negative way actually Shishupal, Dantavarka, Kangsha, they all did preaching for Krishna a very rapid way, very rapidly. But positive preaching is very solid and very slow. Positive preaching is very slow. When Prabhupada speaking so nice Siddhanta, Golok Vani, nobody there to accept it. Nobody can understand his secret Siddhanta. Everybody think that Prabhupada speaking, what he is speaking? We cannot understand. At the bank of Radhakundo also Prabhupada speaking some secret Siddhanta. Prabhupada requesting all devotees, don't go there, come here. You can get lost there. If you go, they are actually sahajya. Don't go there. Come here. I know you are not feeling comfortable with me, but because I am speaking the absolute truth. So this way, actually, nobody can accept this positive preaching properly. Very rare, actually. But positive preaching is very slow and very solid. If you can understand, then you can also go for positive preaching. You can. That is the point. The speciality of Prabhupada, actually we heard from Gurupad Padma and Guru Varga, that you cannot expect that kind of personality in this material world. Not possible. Actually, it's impossible to see a personality like Prabhupada. And all Acharya came here in this material planet up to this point, up to today. So many Acharyas coming here in this material planet, but Prabhupada is exclusive in nature. You cannot compare actually. If we see the Radharani is there with us, she can speak something to us, and Prabhupada speaking same thing. What we can expect from Radharani? Same Siddhanta, same Vani, Prabhupada speaking. So this kind of sense Siddhanta we cannot expect from Ramanujacharya, we cannot expect from Madhvacharya, we cannot expect from Nimbarkacharya, it's not possible. Why? Because up to that point they can speak. Because up to that kippa, their kippa is up to that point. They are requested, they have their order to preach up to that point. But Prabhupada, he can speak very secret thing, but nobody can understand. That is the main point. Gurupada Padma saying that in Chaitanya Math, when Chaitanya Math was established after that, you see, that in the morning time Prabhupada used to move here and hither and thither in lawn, Prabhupada, there. And that time all our Guru Varga, Sundaranda Vidya Vinod, that time. After that he leaving Prabhupada, Sundaranda Vidya Vinod, Srila Bhakti Pramod Puri Goswami Maharaj, Pranamananda Prabhu, and so many devotees, they are ready with diary and pen. They know Prabhupada now going to give this dictation, actually. Nishikanta Sanyal, Sundaranda Vidya Vinod, Bhakti Pranamananda Puri Goswami Maharaj, that time Brahmachari. So they all know Pranamananda Prabhu, Paramananda Prabhu, they are ready with diary. Because they know what Prabhupada is going to do now, what kind of leela. Then that time Prabhupada giving instruction to Sundaranda Vidya Vinod, Gaudiya article. And giving instruction for Nadia Prakas to Pranamananda Prabhu. He is giving instruction for one nice booklet to somebody. This way, Prabhupada moving here and there in long and giving instruction. Up to what point you write? Okay, now write this point. This way, Guru Prabhupada was saying, we cannot imagine that kind of personality. How is that possible? At a time, simultaneously, Prabhupada speaking this point, this Siddhanta. How is that possible? It's not possible. And Guru Prabhupada was saying also, you can find in Saraswati Jayasri, one Bengali book published, you know, Saraswati Jayasri. There also you can find, in Dhaka, now Bangladesh Dhaka, there in Jhulanbari one place, Prabhupada started speaking Harikatha, Prabhupada was invited there, he is speaking all Kartik Vrata, full Kartik Vrata. Prabhupada explaining the Janmadasayata Sloka. For 1 month, Prabhupada speaking, and at the same time Harinam going on. How strange! Prabhupada speaking Harikatha, Janmadasa Slok, at the same time chanting Harinam. Because 3 lakhs Harinam under the guidance of Namacharya Haridas Thakur, Prabhupada is going on. How is that possible? We cannot expect that kind of personality. Material people or other sampradaya, they cannot understand the Siddhanta of Prabhupada. One time, Gorakhpur one place, from there, Gita Press, they writing one letter to Chaitanya Math, Bhagavaya Chaitanya Mission, that please you write one nice writing about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Siddhanta so that we can print it in our magazine. They requested Prabhupada. The Prabhupada started writing, after completing, he sent the full article to them. But after publishing the magazine, we find only certain portion of the magazine was published. They couldn't publish the whole. Then Prabhupada writing later, why you publish Shampad? They simply say we don't have space to. Actually, point is that they have no, they couldn't feel it comfortable. Because so exclusive Siddhanta, very dangerous. So this way, You cannot expect that kind of preaching. You cannot expect that kind of preaching at present. Up to Parampuja Siddhar Goswami Maharaj, up to Srila Bhakti Puri Goswami Maharaj, we have seen some preaching. But that kind of preaching at present rare, impossible. At present nobody, because first of all you will have to take yourself on neutral platform. Because in Chaitanya Charitamrita region, nirapeksha nahile dharma na jay rakshane. If you are not in a neutral platform, then you cannot protect your dharma. I mean, Vaishnava dharma or in social dharma, nothing is just possible for you to protect, give protection, not possible. And whereas for an acharya, it is the only duty of an acharya, the only duty of an acharya is to give full protection to Siddhanta Vani. If Siddhanta Vani is protected, then everything we can protect everything. If Siddhanta Vani gone, then day by day we can get lost. So the only duty of an acharya is to protect Siddhanta Vani. But it is quite impossible to protect Siddhanta Vani. Because to protect Siddhanta Vani not means I can speak nicely Harikatha, I can memorize lot of Siddhanta, Stotra, not that, Sloka. To apply in your whole life, what you can apply in your whole life, that you can speak. What you cannot apply in your whole life, you have no right to speak. Maybe you are a big philosopher, maybe you can speak a lot of philosophy in front of audience, but that is not the symptom of a preacher. Many times, last year also in Puri I also speaking, a flattering personality can never become a preaching personality. Because if you have some anyabhilas, some desire, even some smell of some different desire, then you have no right to speak that absolute truth. Because you cannot speak, because you have some different desire. Anyabhilas, I mean dual conception. If you have one and single point, Advaita Gyan Tattva, if you can see everywhere Krishna, this is not ladies, this is not gents, this is not old man. Everywhere if you can feel Krishna is there, that is called Advaita Gyan Tattva. If you are not established in Advaita Gyan Tattva, then some dual conception must be there. And in Bhagavatam, all Siddhanta is written, Vayam ditiya vinivesatah sat ishat apatasya viparyaya asriti. You can forget, you can lose the link. You cannot get in link with Krishna. You can cut your link because you have anabhilas. You have some dual conception, you have different desire. So you cannot keep track. You can cut the link. Then you can feel disturbance, some agitation, some anxiety can come into you. This way, different kind of problem. Now I like to show you how Prabhupada used to preach. Some sample I like to. Parabhujayat Kesha Goswami Maharaj, Srila Bhakti, Siddhanta, Saraswati Goswami, Thakur, Prabhupada, their preaching is exclusive in nature, you see. So, Prabhupada, from Gauriya mission, Prabhupada sending one missionary team, I mean, full team, to go to Bangladesh, at present in West, I mean, East Bengal. That time East Bengal, now time it is Bangladesh, East Bengal. Prabhupada, that time it was India, now division was not done, so it is India actually. So different part. So Prabhupada's sending one missionary team to Bangladesh. I mean at present Bangladesh, that time in East Bengal, for preaching Harikatha, Narayanganj, Dhaka, in different place. When they going to Dhaka, that time our Bhakti Vivek Bharati Maharaj, big tall figure. Bhakti Vivek Bharati Maharaj, he was there in the team, and so many devotees, they are going for preaching there in East Bengal. I mean, they are in Dhaka, here, there. So they are speaking Harikatha. They are nice, they are explaining the Siddhanta of Gaurang Mahapu, his Leela, pastime, everything. But when Bhaktivyog Bharati Maharaj is speaking all absolute, all about the absolute truth, absolute Siddhanta, then all Sahajiya, they become very angry. They are so angry, they started agitation. You have no right to speak this Katha here, because it is our zone, like medical representative. You know, medical representative, they have some zone. They have some special zone. They visit different doctors in that zone. If you enter into other zone, they say, why you come in an our zone? Like dog, you see dog? A dog in his locality, if you find another dog coming, if you come, go, go, go. Why you are coming here? Go. So this is the condition of present preaching condition. If one realizes while speaking Harikatha, they are in Delhi or in Bombay or in one place, then somebody can come and chase him. Why you are coming in our zone? Why you are speaking Harikatha here? Go to some other place. Like little medical representative. So they also become very angry. They started agitation. And they become very angry. That still they are doing Sankirtan. Maybe somebody coming. Maybe somebody not coming. For me also same thing. I am also under the guidance of Prabhupada. When I was then in Surjakundo, then only one devotee is there to attain my Harikatha. Only. Sometimes nobody. I recite Bhagavatam 7 hours, 8 hours. Continuously. 7 hours, 8 hours. Still, why I am speaking for Krishna? Not for anybody. And maybe sometime thousands of devotees standing in front of me. No different. Because I am not speaking Harikatha for money, a position, nothing. So what it concerns to me, who is going to attain my Harikatha, who is not? This way, Harikatha should be absolute. So there we see, they are speaking Harikatha, but they become very angry, the Sahajiya, they are giving instruction to all devotees, I mean local people, don't go there for Harikatha. Don't attend there. Even in Siliguri, when I went to speak Harikatha, they invited me, some mutt, they give instruction, don't attain Sambhava's Harikatha, it's dangerous Harikatha. Don't go there. So what it concerns to you, I speak the same. Many times it happens so. So I am not disgusted with this point. But if I find degradation of realization like he show me today, then I become very sorry. Bandhamui sabdhan mathe. Whenever we attend Guru Vaishnava anything, Swami Maharaj used to give instruction, preliminary instruction to all foreign devotees. He is sitting in chair, now worship me. Now you see he is foolish. Swami Maharaj sitting in chair, I say, this way you will have to worship Gurupada. If you don't show them, how they can learn? So it is not his patishthasa. This way they give instruction, you see. So, you see, and there they give instruction, don't attend his Harikatha. Don't go there. They are Gaudiya Math, that's very dangerous. Don't go there. And even Maharaj going on Spirikatha, the Gaudiya Math preaching going on, but still one or two people coming, still okay. Then after that they give instruction to all local people that don't give any bhiksha, rice, sweet, anything, money to them. Don't give. If you give them bhiksha, then we can cut you out from this society. You can throw you out from our society. Then we will become very anxious because their team is very strong. They give instruction, don't give any alam, any bhiksha to them. If you give bhiksha, then we are going to throw you away. Like Nanda Baba, you know, Brajavasi, they are all dangerous. Nanda Baba, sometimes those Brajavasis, they coming and giving, they are speaking very harsh in front of Nanda Baba. Hey Nanda, we respect you, we love you. Huh? Your my children, Krishna Balaram, you give name, Gargacharya came, He arranged for name and yajna, everything, secretly horoscope you make. Why you don't invite us? Why? What a reason? Nandava bole, let me hear why I don't speak to you. No, we don't like to hear. Why you don't inform us? Why you don't invite us? So we are going to throw you away from society. Nandavabji, try to understand my point. Gargacharya came, he told me there is dangerous situation in Mathura, Kamsa can any time attack, that's why I am bound to arrange this kind of ceremony here secretly. So you become very angry with us? So this way, you see, then later came to, information came to Prabhupada. Prabhupada, we are in danger now. They are actually very angry with us. They are not attending our Harikatha, giving instruction to our local people not to give any bhiksha to us. What to do? How we can go further with our preaching? Then Prabhupada giving strong instruction to them. Prabhupada speaking, well, they are against you, all against Gauriamat. Okay, you are not getting any rice and wheat, anything as a bhikkha. Well, there is water in Buriganga. There is water in Buriganga. Who is going to stop taking water from Buriganga? You go and drink water from Buriganga and go on preaching about Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Go on preaching. Let me see Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is there or not. Then all devotees, they get power, they get water from Buriganga and drink. They started speaking Harikatha without any prasadam. Then very, very quickly all situation changed. All devotees, they are crying, local people. They say, you are actually demonic character. Why you stop bhiksha? We must give bhiksha to them. They are actually sadhu. They are Gaurima. They started giving alam, bhikya, everything. Then on and on, then preaching took a big form. Narayan Ganj, here, there, all over Bangladesh, they preaching. And all, most of our Guru Varga, they came from there, Bangladesh, you see. Srila Banudev Goswami Maharaj, he came from Bangladesh. Our Tivikka Maharaj, who lived body in Chaitanya Gaurima, used to stay at my Guru Maharaj and Paramja Madhu Goswami Maharaj. He lived body. He was in Bangladesh. So many devotees. Even Bhakti Vilasitha Goswami Maharaj, Kunjoda, he was in Bangladesh. My Guru Maharaj. So many countless devotees there coming from Bangladesh. Even first devotee of Prabhupada. First disciple of Prabhupada. He was from Bangladesh. So what to speak? They started speaking Harikatha. Then and then going on preaching. At present we have so much sophisticated messing and everything. Facilities. Still we cannot do that kind of preaching. How you can expect? That time no printer, printing machine just came. Foot printing. After that machine came from Baharampur. How is that possible to preach so massive way? Whereas no phone, nothing, no facility there. How is that possible? Massive preaching was done. Even Nadia Prakash, daily Nadia Prakash, weekly Gaudiya, even fortnight papers also there, so many books, so many Siddhanta speaking, even in different language also, in Uriya, in Bengali, in Assamese, in English harmonist, you know. This way we become stunned. How is that possible? How much dedication is there? With our Guru Varga, how is that possible? But still they are successful. At present we have so much facilities, so much machinery, so much facility, but still we cannot do that kind of preaching. Is not possible. Prana Chajar Sehitu Prashar. Prabhupada in Vaishnav ke, who is Vaishnav? In this writing Prabhupada speaking, Prana Chajar Sehitu Prashar. If there is no life, the vitals of your life is submission. If it's not there, no use. You don't go for preaching. Don't go for preaching. Your preaching is useless preaching. That's why prana chajar sevitu prachar. Everybody will say, we have pran, we have life. That's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur is speaking, Shikhai Sharanagati Bhakter Pran. What do you mean by pran, life? That explanation Prabhupada giving. Bhaktivinoda Thakur. Bhaktivinoda Thakur is speaking, Shikhai Sharanagati Bhakter Pran. That is a vital, life of your devotional life is Saranagati. That's why Prabhupada told this way. What Prabhupada told? Prana Chaya Sehetu Prabhupada. You can go for preaching if full kripa is there, because Krishna kripa, if it is not there, if Krishna kripa is not there with you, you cannot go for preaching. Krishna kripa, if not, Krishna kripa is not there, then you cannot go for preaching. It is written, Siddhanta is there in Chaitanya Charitamrita, you see, big problem. You can remember many instances, so many devotees there, there are so many people outside, material people, they are against Prabhupada, but still Prabhupada never feel any anxiety, nothing. You can know everything. In preaching, Parikrama party there in Paramatola, Nadia Kulia, they attack so heavily with stone and chief, they attack Prabhupada, but still Prabhupada don't feel disgusted. He go on preaching nicely and never feel disgusted. This way preaching going on, you see, big preaching. Preaching going on. Even in Assam, Punjab, everywhere in South India, everywhere preaching going on. In Assam is a terrific, dangerous place. Assam is very dangerous place previously, you see. Parme Madhav Goswami, I speak one instant, I can come back to Prabhupada. One time Parme Madhav Goswami is going for preaching there. Then Madhav Goswami is speaking, time is very limited. We have so vast place for preaching. So we can do one thing, we can make two or three group. So I can go for preaching here, and you can, with some devotee, you can preach here, and somebody with some group can go there. This way we can go rapid preaching. This way, Madhav Goswami is giving instruction. He himself going to some place for preaching, and preaching going on, night time, evening time, preaching going on, and some devotee is running and coming with full anxiety and speaking to Parampuja Madhav Goswami, Gurudev, there is dangerous situation, what happens? They are preaching going on, actually, we started preaching there, some people, local people came, they are all actually started beating all devotees. All they crack their head, everything, blood coming on, big attack on preaching party. So they are all sent to hospital, this, that. Then Paramahansa Madhav Goswami Maharaj, sometime he looked to Gurupad Padma's lotus feet. Madhav Paramahansa Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati concentrated his mind and speaking, Ha Krishna! This single word. Nothing else. Ha Krishna! One single word. Hot breath coming. Breathing, you see? Hot air coming from nose. This. Ha Krishna. This single word is sufficient, more than sufficient. Then night time, all mad elephant came from forest. Those who attracted those devotees, their family member, their building, their all, crop fields, all demolished, elephant coming. Killing them, elephant fill, mad elephant coming and giving their right appropriate answer to them, those who are attacking devotees. You see the power of our Guru Varga. You see the power of our Guru Varga. How I can speak? This way Prabhupada started preaching in Assam also. First preaching started by Prabhupada. Then Paramahansa Madhav Goswami also speaking. Then Nimananda Prabhu, Nimananda Prabhu, one devotee is of one, I mean, associate of Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami. Only to Nimananda Prabhu, Prabhupada giving instruction, you can give Harinam for me. You can representative. You are my representative. You can give Harinam for me because I have no time to come here in Assam all the time. First of all, you give Harinam to them. It is my instruction to you. After that, if you feel they are going up and up in bhajan, then you can bring them to Mayapur because they are poor people. You also no time because Nimananda Prabhu, he was actually grihastha devotees. But still so power Prabhupada giving him. Nimananda Prabhu. At present also you can find so much devotees there in Assam of Nimananda Prabhu. By the instruction of Prabhupada giving. This way you see, preaching going on. One time, big preaching going on there. And not only that, Parampuja Bhaktisiddhanta Madhava Goswami at that time, Hayagriva Brahmachari and Parampujivad, Srila Bhakti Rakhak Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, he was Ramananda Prabhu, and so many devotees there going there to establish one Gaudiya Math there, as per the instruction of Prabhupada. It is quite impossible, but still they are trying because full kripa is there of Prabhupada. They are trying their best, and ultimately they become successful. In Sarbhog, one place is there in Sarbhog, you know, Sarbhog in Assam. Sarbhog, first Gaudiya Math was established there in Sarbhog by Prabhupada. But at the time of establishment of that man and at establishment of deities, one incident I would like to project in form that you can give feel inspiration. As a Siddhanta Prabhupada, you see. So that time, Prabhupada went to Assam for establishing mutt and deities. That time, those devotees, they are going to accept Prabhupada in train. And from station, they put Prabhupada on elephant. And with big procession, they are coming with Sankirtan, very big Sankirtan, they are coming with Prabhupada. They are very happy. That local people, they are from outside, they are all coming, all dancing. After that, Prabhupada coming into new Gaudiya Math, going to be established. Then Prabhupada, I also see that, visit that place, because that time I was speaking Harikatha there, in some, near Kokrajhar, one place is there, I was speaking Harikatha. I went there, and same place is there, one small room is there. There Prabhupada used to do bhajan, some days Prabhupada staying there. Then Prabhupada giving instruction to Ramananda Prabhu, Srila Parampuja Sridhar Goswami Maharaj and Parampuja Madhava Goswami Maharaj, that you please arrange everything there for jagya and all ceremony, rituals you see we need. So you arrange everything, then you call me. First of all, mandir establishment was done. After that, question of deity establishment. Then Prabhupada speaking, you arrange everything, then call me, I can come from my room and I can start. Then Parampuribhat Bhakti Rakhav Sridhar Goswami, Ramananda Prabhu, he went inside Garbha Mandir, inside temple, he arranged everything there. Not only that, new deities coming, he cleaned all deities, and after that, without abhishek, out of love, strong love, he giving on ornament, everything, cloth, after this putting garland to deities. I don't know how. Then Prabhupada giving information to Prabhupada, now everything arranged, Prabhupada, you can please come. And now we can start our abhishek. Then Prabhupada coming, Prabhupada, some screen is there, open and go inside. And Prabhupada, what is that? Why you call me? Actually, Pratishtha done. Nobody can understand what Prabhupada speaking. Prabhupada speaking already Pratishtha done. What use? DTI installment? DTI already installed by the love and affection of strong affinity of Ramananda Prabhu. He gives garland. This is the Siddhanta of Ramanuja. Ramanuja Acharya speaking same thing. If one deity is there, you put deities, but there is no life. If one high mani, power devotee is coming and paying dandavat, I mean with strong love for Krishna, paying dandavat for her deities, then automatically life can come inside. This is secret Siddhanta. Same Siddhanta we can find with Parampujvat Janardhan Goswami Maharaj. Janardhan Maharaj, he was in Kharagpur. He was a disciple of Prabhupad. Close face friendship with Parampujvat Bhakti, Vedanta Bhaman Goswami Maharaj. Close friendship. One time he give order for Prabhupada deities, Prabhupada's Vigraha, to Jaipur. And on right time, from Jaipur Vigraha coming to his, temple, already coming. And somebody giving information to Gurudev, already deity coming in car. It was in packing, big packing. Wooden and some straw, big packing. Then Parampribhat, Janardhan Goswami coming in front of that car where Prabhupada is there inside packing and crying, "Hey, get out! Quickly, you bring arati, everything. Arati pot. I like to do arati." And they break that, they open that packing and put Prabhupada in nice asan. He started doing arati. Then people can say he is a crazy personality. Not that. People can misunderstand him. No abhishek, nothing, no deity installment. How he started arati? In front of you, his question is different. In front of that devotee, his question is different. That's why Gurupad Padma and Prabhupada used to say same thing, that Vigraha is saprakas, self-effort, self-manifestation. Forcefully you cannot bring Krishna in that devotee, deities. That's why many times we hear Prabhupada speaking, it is not possible to establish temple, it is not possible to establish deities. It is not possible. You have money power, so you can establish one temple and deities. It is not possible, Prabhupada used to say. It is not possible to establish one temple out of your money power. It is not possible to establish deities out of your money power. Only devotion, only exclusive devotion, love, can bring Krishna into the deities. That's why Ramanuja ji also speaking same thing for ordinary devotees. Don't pay dandavat to any deities not established by pure devotees. Any Shivalinga established by material people, don't pay dandavat because there is no life. This is the glories of Vaishnava, you see. This way preaching going on. Then Prabhupada now feeling it is necessary to bring send preaching team to foreign also. Some devotees in front of Prabhupada speaking, "Prabhupada, you are so lucky, you are so powerful. Within this short time you are establishing Gaudiya Math all over India. 64 Gaudiya Math you established all over India. Because 64 folds of devotional mode. So you established 64 temples, Gaudiya Math all over India." Prabhupada saying, "Oh no, don't speak like that. Don't speak like that. I like to establish Gaudiya Math inside the heart of all people. You are speaking only 64 Gaudiya Math established. You are dancing. I am very unhappy. Because I cannot establish, Gaudiya Math inside the heart of all devotees. If I cannot establish Gaudiya Math inside your heart, then I should not come to speak Harikatha in front of you. I have no right. I am not the member of Gauriya Math. Because with member of Gauriya Math, Gauriya Math already moving. Prabhupada speaking. Because they are living Mirdanga. Prabhupada speaking. Those who are dedicated soul, those who are giving everything to Krishna, those who are giving everything to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, not that he can reserve something for his own use. Oh, this is for me, this is for Krishna, this is for Gurudev, this is for us. Not for them. Those who are giving their life, those who are giving their property, those who are giving their everything unto the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I mean unto the lotus feet of Prabhupada, I mean Guru Bhargava, only for them. This word, Prabhupada speaking. These all devotees you see, they are all sannyasis, they are all dedicated show, they are all living Mridanga. One Mridanga you can play here, up to that point they can hear. After that nobody can hear the sound of Mridanga you are playing so nicely. But my Mridanga, I make Mridanga, that's my Guru Varga, I mean. They can go anywhere. France, Italy, America, any state you can see. Without free hand, without Mani Baba, nothing. They can go and start preaching and make thousands of temples. Swami Maharaj example, Banu Goswami Maharaj, Siddhar Goswami Maharaj, they are living Mridanga. This is the condition of power. Living Mridanga. We should be living Mridanga. Full of fire, Siddhanta, Vichar, purity, all at a time. Not that he can speak Siddhanta, no purity is there, not possible. All at a time, simultaneously it is going to stay there. Simultaneously, purity, devotion, everything can come at a time. Purity means internal purity, external purity. Prabhupada used to speak this way. Internal purity means always you have unbreakable link with Krishna. Internal purity. Ja swaretha pundarika aksham sava jhavantaram suchi. Yes, we speak mantra every time. Purity. If you can think continuously lotus feet of Guru Pad Padma, then you are pure. And external purity means your clothes should be up to that level, so you can sit on Vyasasana, you can worship deity, that much purity you must maintain. And for Abadut, that is different thing. Abadut there, I already speak many times to those devotees. Jnananishtho viraktova madbhaktova anapekshakaha shalinganam asramam stakta charet avidhi gochara. Charet avidhi, they are beyond any rules. Jnananishtho viraktova madbhaktova anapekshakaha shalinganam asramam stakta chaturvarna and asram. You cannot confine them within that limit. Gaurakishore Bhaji Maharaj, Prabhupad, Bhakti Mahapuri. But still they are exhibiting varnasam dharma they are maintaining. To control me. To give guidance. Gaurakishore Bhaji Maharaj exclusive. Bhangshidas Bhaji Maharaj exclusive. Bhagwan Das Bhaji Maharaj exclusive. Prabhupad is also exclusive. But still, Prabhupad saying it is the responsibility on me to preach. So I must maintain everything. And Gaurakishore Bhaji Maharaj, he need not maintain anything. Always is pure. Well, Vaishnava is always pure. But to teach you, he maintain purity. He is also pure. All the time he has continuous remembrance of Krishna. But still he so purity. Pure place, pure thing. This kind of Siddhanta, you must maintain, because otherwise all people can mislead. You can mislead, huh? It's very dangerous. So, this way preaching going on all over the world, but before sending any messenger to foreign country, Prabhupada meet with Rabindranath Thakur in some place. Rabindranath Thakur, you know, Nobel Prize owner, poet, Rabindranath Tagore, That time, what time I am speaking, he just came back from England. After winning Nobel Prize, he came back. So, sometime they used to come to meet Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada. So, this way, somehow they meet in one place, and each one, Prabhupada speaking Harikatha to Rabindranath Thakur. Many times it happens so. Many times. In Shillong, here, there, many times, Rabindranath Thakur used to meet Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, they used to speak Harikatha to them. I mean, the team. So now, first question Prabhupada speaking. You are just coming from foreign country, from England? Well, yes. So now it is my question, what kind of positive result can I get? Positive result if I send some messenger there in foreign country, European country? What do you think? Rabindranath Thakur speaking, it is very negative point. If you can send, but you cannot get response properly. Then Prabhupada become very harsh, because Rabindranath is not spiritual personality. Then Prabhupada all on a sudden, the moment he speak like that, you can get some result, not so big response. Positive response you cannot expect. Then all of a sudden Prabhupada started speaking Harikatha in front of Rabindranath Thakur. Continuously for 2 hours Prabhupada speaking Harikatha. And Rabindranath is stunned, he's hearing. After Harikatha is finished, he fold his hand, excuse me, I speak wrongly. Any personality like you going to foreign country can come out successful. This is my comment now. You can send. See the point. So this way, preaching going on, Bhakti Pratip Tithu Goswami Maharaj was sent, Sir Banadev Goswami Maharaj was sent. This way preaching party going on. Goswami Maharaj was sent, and Paramahansa Sridhar Goswami Maharaj was supposed to send. Prabhupada saying, Prabhupada many times spoke. Paramahansa Sridhar Goswami Maharaj is the number one preacher in Gauriya field. Many times. My Guru Maharaj used to love Sridhar Goswami Maharaj from heart. I don't know how much love I have for his lotus feet. I cannot, because it is one kind of advertisement. So I don't want to do any kind of advertisement. Last time when Sridhar Goswami Maharaj going to leave his body, my Guru Maharaj sitting in outside and crying whole day and night. Maharaj, you are going to leave us. Then you can understand what is the relation between one Vaishnava and another. At present you can feel some sort of hatred. Oh, don't go there. What kind of love? What kind of magical love? Guru Maharaj coming from Navadvip station, full devotees there, many devotees. I mean, Parampuja Sridhar Goswami Maharaj, with Parampuja Madhav Goswami Maharaj, Guru Maharaj went to some place. Now coming back to Mayapur, then Guru Maharaj drop in Navadvip station, then get one car. When Ganga Bridge coming, Guru Maharaj feels some inspiration. Guru Maharaj speaking, Paramahansa Bhaktivinoda Thakur Goswami. Oh, stop car. Why Maharaj? We are going to Mayapur. No stop car. I feel attraction for Sridhar Goswami Maharaj. You drop me here. You go to Mayapur. I feel I should drop here. Then they give drop. Then Guru Maharaj come. They have interrelation. Their heart, they're locking. Guru Maharaj is coming to temple and see Paramahansa Madhav Goswami Maharaj is sick. Then from heart Krishna speaking. This way their relation, you see. He was supposed to send to foreign country first. I mean, Paramahansa Bhakti Pratipthitu Goswami Maharaj, Sridhar Goswami Maharaj. But somehow situation was changed. Because in heart, Ramananda Prabhu feeling, oh, Prabhupada sending me to foreign country. So I don't think I am fit. I can stay in front of Prabhupada, Prabhupada can give some seva here. If this can occur, but still the instruction of Prabhupada I should obey. Then all of a sudden Prabhupada saying, change his decision. then Ramananda Prabhu laughing, oh! Laughing. Prabhupada, hear my heart. But still, when all foreign devotees, they coming to Paramahansa Siddhar Goswami Maharaj, Prabhupada looking the lotus feet of Prabhupada, oh Prabhupada, first of all, you wanted to give me instruction to go to foreign country to speak Harikatha in front of foreign devotees. So I cannot violate. Now they are coming to me. You bless me, I can speak Harikatha now. Now speaking Harikatha. All day and night in old age, 3 times, 4 times, noon time, morning time, evening time, all speaking Harikatha. All big, big spiritual gigant in your spiritual life. Guru Varga, but still we are not getting power. What is the reason? Can you speak? What is the reason behind it? Prabhupada gives so many power to us. Prabhupada giving so many power. Goswami Maharaj wanted to live, wanted to speak Harikatha in front of Queen and King of England. But they don't allow any outside people to go inside and speak any. Oh, Rabbi, we cannot. Somehow they arrange, I mean, Goswami Maharaj. Goswami Maharaj somehow get some 10 minutes time. Okay, we can allow only 10 minutes time to you speak some message and across the dining table. No other, we have so many engagement. Only across the dining table, you can speak Harikatha, we can take prasad. I mean, they are not taking prasad, they are our rabbis. I speak prasad, it is my habit. They are speaking. Goswami Maharaj said, okay, if you have no other time, I can speak Harikatha. Then Goswami Maharaj speaking in front of the queen and, I mean, they are eating lunch. Eh? Then Goswami Maharaj speaking. 1 hour gone, they cannot feel that 1 hour gone. 10 minutes time they allow. This way they feel, I mean, enthusiastic power. You are coming from India? Eh? You are giving the message of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Oh, so nice. They feel inspiration. And I like to speak some Siddhanta of secret Siddhanta of regarding YuktaVairagya. It's very secret point. Because You can show outside people, I am YuktaVairagya, so I am doing this way. But at all there is no YuktaVairagya inside you. You like to enjoy. You like to engage your sense organ for enjoyment. YuktaVairagya is very secret thing. YuktaVairagya, if you like to understand YuktaVairagya, you will have to understand the devotion of Gopikas. You will have to understand the devotion of Radharani. But I cannot go back to that point now. I can come back someday. If you can go up in bhajan day by day, if you bless me, someday I can speak about that. But not now. You will have to prove. You have to prove that you are going up in bhajan. Then I can give some time. Otherwise I have no time. I am like labor working there in Goshala, here they have no time, I cannot manage time. I can spare some time, because of the instruction of Prabhupada. Okay, but that should be very controlled way, not freely. To YuktaVairagya, we like to understand this point, it's a very secret point. Prabhupada speaking, in front of devotees, the question of YuktaVairagya is very secret thing. Balanced Vairagya. Balanced. Very. Parampaja Siddhar Goswami used to say, or Guru Bhaga used to say, all proper adjustment. All proper adjustment for Krishna Seva. Not adjustment. All proper and perfect adjustment for Krishna Seva. I can give one or two examples so you can You can try to feel. Gopad giving instruction to Banadev Goswami Maharaj, Bega Banadev Goswami Maharaj, Bhaktipati Tithu Goswami Maharaj, Banadev Goswami Maharaj, and Bhakti Vaikhanus Goswami Maharaj, Vaikhanus Goswami Maharaj, is a big Pandit, Odisha, from Odisha zone, Ambapua, one place. Vaikhanus Goswami Maharaj, big personality in spiritual life. Prabhupada giving instantly Diksha and Sannyas, very quickly, within 1 month or 2 months. It is not possible for Prabhupada to give, but Prabhupada give them. Have some reason, have some secret reason, who can say? Prabhupada giving Sannyas to them very quickly, within 6 months. Otherwise, Prabhupada wait, after giving Harimam, Prabhupada wait for 2 years, 3 years, 4 years, wait. Can he do Hari Bhajan? What do you think? Sometimes our devotees speaking, asking Prabhupada, Prabhupada, can we allow Diksha to them? I mean, can you allow Diksha to them, those devotees? Prabhupada speaking, oh no. Let their hearing organ be engaged in Harikatha continuously. Their hearing organ, if they can engage in Harikatha continuously, non-stop, Harikitan, Harikatha, not that, 2 hours I do Harikatha. Now stop. I can take retire, take rest, not that. Those who are devotees, they are established devotees. They are super personality. They are Harikatha Kirtan going on continuously in their life, non-stop Harikatha. Even they are speaking in front of you or not in front of you, it makes no difference. They are speaking Harikatha all the time, like mad inside, Harikatha going on. So time-bound program is for you and me. This time-bound program is not even approved for those Prabhupada, Paramahansa Kesava Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Prabhupada Goswami Maharaj, Paramahansa Sridhara Goswami Maharaj, for not them. Continuously Harikatha. I can come back to this point. Now Prabhupada giving instruction to Banadev Goswami Maharaj. You go, change your dress and put on coat and pant and tie and shoe and come in front of me. Banadev Goswami says, what's that? I am sannyasi. How I can put on coat and everything? It is my instruction, you go. You go and put on coat and pant and tie and hat and shoe and come in front of me. Repeatedly Prabhupada saying. Then Banadev Goswami Maharaj, what to do? I don't know why Prabhupada, what kind of lila this is. Then in front of Prabhupada, you come in front of me. Then Banadev Goswami Maharaj coming in front of me, very shy. Now come this point. This is called YuktaVairagya. This is called YuktaVairagya. Because you are doing for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, for Krishna. You have no desire to put on coat and pant, everything tied. You are going for, because Gopikas, they are putting all ornaments and clothes, everything nice, even decoration there, all for Krishna's benefit, to make Krishna happy. There is no trace, no smell of personal benefit. So this is called YuktaVairagya. Come on. This way you will have to go. Goswami Maharaj, Banadev Goswami Maharaj, they all exhibit this kind of YuktaVairagya. Sometime, Sir Anderson from England, Sir Anderson with his wife came from England. They are invited to Gauriamath. Prabhupada giving order, because you see YuktaVairagya, nobody can understand. They can misunderstand Prabhupada. Or they can try to imitate. They can try to imitate Prabhupada. Because those who are devils, they also can quote scriptures. Hiranyakashipu also quoting scriptures sometimes. But that is not approved by devotees. So sometimes somebody can say, well, Prabhupada approved this, so I can also do it. Not that. Only Prabhupada have the right to do it. You have no right. Prabhupada giving lunch order to Grand Hotel. material hotel, one grand hotel, some special digs coming for Sir Anderson in Gauriya Mutt. And Prabhupada speaking Harikatha in front of them, they are taking prasadam. Many of devotees, they misunderstand Prabhupada. They cannot understand Prabhupada. What is the mood? Then after that, when Prabhupada said they cannot understand my point, then Prabhupada like lion speaking. You see, I can come down to any level for the actual preaching of Chaitanya Vani. I can come down to any level for the actual preaching of Chaitanya Vani. Rapid preaching, actual preaching of Chaitanya Vani, Prabhupada speaking like this. Many times, very, very big, big personality in spiritual, material world or spiritual world also, they coming and giving submission, showing submission to Prabhupada. They are coming in front of Prabhupada and crying. Like BHU established by whom? BHU, Benaras Hindu University. Established by, many times I speak, why you forget? He came, he is big Pandit. And in front, Madan Mohan Malabhya. Madan Mohan Malabhya. In India, it is a super personality, big personality in Indian background. He established BHU, Benaras Hindu University. So many very powerful, all big Pandit. Nobody can fight with him. He came in front of Prabhupada because that time the preaching of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was going on in full flight. And Madan Mohan Malabhya came in Bhagavad Gauriya mission. He meet Prabhupada and hear Harikatha. After that, he's crying and falling down to the lotus feet of Prabhupada. Prabhupada, I can speak today one perfect thing. What is that? But in front of nobody, I show submission. Only in front of this kind of personality, your personality, I feel I should give submission, so submission in front of you. Very strange. I never see this kind of personality in my whole life. In my whole life, I never see this kind of gigantic personality like you. You can solve any problem in my heart, I know. That's why I show submission. Please save me. This way. Prabhupada. This way preaching going on. Goswami Maharaj preaching. Siddhar Goswami Maharaj preaching. Bhaktivati Tithu Goswami Maharaj preaching. They are all preaching. Keeping Prabhupada in front. In Indian base also, many times, many devotees, Hayagri Brahmachari, Banu Goswami Maharaj, Prabhupada Siddhar Goswami Maharaj, they are all going for Indian bases. Indian field. South Indian field, North Indian, they are going for preaching. Prabhupada give instruction, you must establish one mat, Gauriya Mutt in Madras. It's quite impossible. For a long time, they are trying. Because this is Shankaracharya's field. It is Ramanujacharya's field. It is Madhyacharya's field. They are all great scholar, erudite scholar. It is not possible to break their Siddhanta. If you have proper Guru Kipa, then and only then you can. So they are going on preaching. After that, what happens? They invite Prabhupada. Invite Prabhupada. In Madras and Kobur, you know? Kobur one place. Ramananda, Rai Ramananda and Mahaprabhu, they discussed some secret points at the bank of Godavari, there in South India. There also. Sometime Prabhupada came in Kobur, and speaking Harikatha so nicely. Ramananda Sangbad is speaking in English. And sometime Prabhupada going to some place, speaking in Bengali. Continuously about 2 hours, speaking in Bengali. Then all devotees, they requesting Prabhupada, you are speaking in Bengali? they don't understand Bengali. We don't know what is this, what kind of lila you are manifesting, you are speaking in Bengali, whereas they don't understand Bengali. Prabhupada looking at them, see, I am not speaking Bengali. I am not speaking Hindi. I am not speaking English. I am not speaking Malayalam. I am speaking Harikatha. Then they become stunned. I am speaking Harikatha. I am not speaking Bengali. My Guru Maharaj also used to speak to those foreign devotees. That time they used to come. You can speak in Bengali. You can request all devotees, the Guru Maharaj used to say. You can sit there and hear Bengali Harikatha. Oh, we cannot understand. So what? You cannot understand, but transcendental sound vibration can touch your heart. How is that possible that Narottama Thakur going to Mizoram and Tripura, Mizoram, Nagaland, whereas there nobody is, Manipur, they don't understand Bengali, they don't understand English, they don't understand Hindi, nothing. How is that possible? Narottama Thakur going there, sitting in one temple and crying and doing kirtan. So nice kirtan, playing kartal, nobody there, only alone, doing kirtan. Pasane kotibo matha anale posibo gorango guner nidhi kotha gele pabo, doing kirtan, so nice. Then all people around him, they are all foolish. They are crying with Narottama Thakur. They don't understand language, nothing. Why they are crying? Narottama Thakur crying and doing kirtan. Gora pohu nabho jiyamai. So nice kirtan. Then all people around Narottama Thakur, they are shedding tears. Why they are shedding tears? Because it's transcendental sound vibration touching their heart, and inside heart Paramatma is there. Krishna is there in front of the form of Paramatma. Pashupaki jure pashana bidare suni jare harikatha. I mean gunagatha. Narottama Thakur like? About Gauranga Mahaprabhu? Pashupaki jure pashana bidare suni jare harik gunagatha. About Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Narottama Thakur speaking Siddhanta, even stone can melt. Even those birds, they can shedding tears. All possible. Not possible? Not possible? I can give instruction from Benu Gita, I can give from Gopi Gita, there also I can sow. Hantayam madridavala haridasa varyo yad Ram Krishna charano parasho pramodo. So nice. 100% is possible. Krishna playing on fruit, all stone melting. And Jamuna Nadi getting stone, ice. Exchange of property. Only possible. It's possible. So this way, you see, Prabhupada proved. Many times, how much time I can speak? Whole life is me, if I can speak about Prabhupada, I cannot finish. Many times it happens so. In Chaitanya Math was just established. There are no place to sit devotees where Prabhupada can speak Harikatha. Very small place, then all sitting in garden. Then many times it happens so. Prabhupada speaking Harikatha, they are all lost. For what Prabhupada speaking, they are hearing. And somebody catching some branch. After Harikatha upar, he discovered it is not the part of trees, it is snack. Snack. 2 hours he is catching, his thing is just like in some creeper, maybe some creeper he is catching. But snake is just shut up. Sometime Prabhupada speaking Harikatha, in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu just established. Here all Mataji is there sitting right side, left side Mataji is right side, or and Pitajis, Matajis of our Pitajis, gents and ladies. They are sitting, then Sri Prabhupada speaking Harikatha, all are reciting, Prabhupada sing, one cobra is coming, big cobra. And coming in front of seat of Prabhupada speaking Harikatha is sitting this way. They become frightened, Prabhupada speaking, stop. Don't speak anything. It's Anantadev. You sit and hear Harikatha is coming here to bless us. Can hear Harikatha and go away. Don't get disturbance. Don't fear. Then Prabhupada finished Harikatha. After that, if going on. Just some days before, I mean maybe 6 months or 8 months before, one doctor, he respects me so much. He coming to my library. I'm working, and all on a sudden phone came. Maharaj, phone came from his house. And in phone, what message he received? His wife speaking, you speak to Maharaj because you are going to Maharaj. I know. You are in front of Maharaj now? Yes. You speak to Maharaj. Some snake coming to in front of my gate. I mean just inside gate. And that snake not going away. He is just this way. We are very afraid. You inform Maharaj. They give the... I say you give instruction to your wife. Is Anantadev. Don't fear. You get one ganta and arati plate. And do arati. Dup and dip. Everything light. You do arati and offer some flower. And go away. Instantly. After half an hour, 1 hour, you inform me. Okay, Maharaj, you give instruction. No, same. Going away. I am going to speak Harikatha in Dauji Mandir in Vrindavan. I am staying in Pandavali Kunj at the bank of Jamuna. There is many snacks staying inside. All broken house. So, all foreign devotees, they are waiting in Dauji Mandir. I am supposed to come. Then all of a sudden, because I saw today, I feel disgusted. Because before speaking Harikatha, I don't speak even one single word. With full meditation, I come, I don't speak anything in front of me. I don't speak, I don't hear anything. Just I come and sit in Vyasasana, this is my system. Now today I feel disgusted. That day also said, I was supposed to come out of gate, then I find one snack is there. Now what time is there? I'm supposed to speak Harikatha 4:30 there. How I can go? Then I pray my, I don't fly. The snack is there, I fold my hand. Prabhu, can you allow me to go and speak Harikatha there? It is your seva, not my seva. Then I am going back to my room. Then all of a sudden, snack going away. Snack going away. Leaving this, giving me place. I come and speak Harikatha, pay dandavat to Dauji and speak Harikatha. So many times this happens so. So this way. So you must believe. You must believe 100%. You must believe 100%. Prabhupada many times shedding tears. You all promised me to do Harikatha. That's why you came in front of me. Now you are cheating me. You all promised me to do Harikatha. You promised me. That's why I give you Harinam Diksha. Now you want to cheat me? What's that? Speaking this way. So this way, Prabhupada going on preaching and preaching. So nice. So many Siddhanta and Vichara I can remember. I cannot speak. Because time is very limited, very short time. I feel very sorry. Now I can speak the moment when Prabhupada leaves his body. A special moment. That time, you see, my Gurupad Padma Sila Bhakti Pramod Purigashi Maharaj, I mean Paramananda Prabhu, Punamananda Prabhu, my Guru Maharaj, and Paramananda Prabhu, that time he was the sevak of Guru Prabhupada. Sevak of Prabhupada. They are doing seva continuously for 24 hours. 12 hours my Guru Maharaj, Brahmachari, and 12 hours Paramananda Prabhu. Continuous speaking Harikatha. Prabhupada going to Puri, I mean Purushottam Khetra. Prabhupada staying there in Chatak Parvat, you know, Chatak Parvat. There for some days. And Prabhupada Keshav Goswami Maharaj, I mean Vinod Prabhu, he is crying in front of Prabhupada. Prabhupada, you are expressing some sick lila. We are very afraid. We are very anxious. Then Prabhupada with tears, speaking the last word to Vinoda, Vinod Prabhu. See, now I don't feel any necessary to stay in this material planet. Because nobody can understand my Siddhanta. Nobody can accept my Siddhanta. So I don't feel any necessity to stay more in this material world. Thus, this is what came. Then Prabhupada started Asustha Leela, Sikh Leela, on and on, going on Asustha Leela. From there, my Guru Maharaj also was there in that team. When Prabhupada paid last visit to Chatak Parvat, then full team with Prabhupada came to Tidandi Mat in Bhuvaneshwar, you know. They also speak Prabhupada some Harikatha. They also, Prabhupada, sometime joking with my Guru Maharaj. Love my Guru Maharaj, you say. You see, Pranamananda Prabhu. Prabhupada speaking in front of all devotees in room. We should give Siddhanta, I must give Siddhanta, I must give sannyas to Pranamananda Prabhu. Pranamananda, I mean my Guru Maharaj. We should give sannyas to him. This way. Okay, let me see. After that Prabhupada came. From there Prabhupada passing this remark. Only this remark. We should give Siddhanta, I mean sannyas to Pranamananda Prabhu. This much. After that Prabhupada came to Chaitanya Gauriya Mission. And Bhagavad Gauriya Mission with full team. Then after that, Prabhupada expressing more and more Sikh Leela. Doctor coming to Prabhupada to attend. Then Prabhupada complaining, they don't allow me to speak Harikatha because you give instruction to them, don't allow Prabhupada to speak Harikatha. But believe me, when I speak Harikatha, then I feel happy. I mean, my health become very good. So, this way, in front of Dr. Prabhupada, used to complain. He gave instruction to them, don't allow Prabhupada to speak Harikatha, but believe me, when I speak Harikatha, I feel happy. I feel... Otherwise, if you don't allow me to speak Harikatha, I feel sick. This way, on and on, Prabhupada expressing Sikh Leela. Then Pranamananda and Pranamananda Prabhu do Brahmacharis, they are 12 hours, I mean 24 hours doing seva, 24 hours. My Guru Maharaj used to stay night time, I mean from evening 6 to morning 6, 5 to 5, then 6 to 6, this way, speaking. Then when Guru Maharaj leaving in the morning time, 5 o'clock, I mean almost 5 o'clock, Paramananda Prabhu coming inside room, then on oxygen final and everything, I mean to that devotee who is going to do further seva. Then all on a sudden, Guru Maharaj crying. I mean Paramananda Prabhu crying. Paramananda, please come. Guru Maharaj going out from room, step by step going, and feeling all vacant. Because we are going to lose Prabhupada. Step by step, Prabhupada coming out from room and thinking heavily. Very feeling, deep feeling. He seeing all vacant. Darkness all around. Prabhupada going away from us, we think so. All lotus sign and Pranamananda calling, Pranamananda, come on, quickly. What happens? He ran and entered the room. All finished. Prabhupada gone. Last, Nishanto Leela. I mean, Radharani and Govinda, strong embracement. Gauranga Mahaprabhu then. Radha and Govinda submerge, and one unique Gauranga avatar exhibiting golden complexion. That time, Prabhupada living. Nishanto Leela, last Leela, most sensitive Leela. Then Guru Maharaj crying, everybody crying, everywhere also, everywhere, all over India, message going on. Prabhupada leave his body. Then Guru Maharaj speaking, one strange we find there. So many clock there in room. So many clock. But all clock when Prabhupada leave body, living body, stuck up in one place. In temple, so many clock, but all clock there stand still. At the time of Guru Maharaj's 100-year ceremony, I was giving responsibility to edit Bengali and so many magazines. There, I wanted to publish some short life sketch of my Guru Maharaj's devotional life. Guru Maharaj himself speaking something, we note, and we wanted to publish. And this Siddhanta we published. Guru Maharaj spoke. All clock there stand still. Prabhupada leave this body. From material planet, Prabhupada going away. Now today, we are alone, we see. But still, if we deeply concentrate, we can see that Prabhupada is there with his Siddhanta. All the time inside our heart, Prabhupada is there. So to satisfy Prabhupada is to satisfy Vani Siddhanta. Protect Vani Vaibhav. If you can give whole life for protection of Vani Vaibhav, don't speak useless Siddhanta. Don't speak Siddhanta not approved by Prabhupada. Don't speak that Siddhanta. Then you can get, automatically you can get power and blessings from Prabhupada. Prabhupada is there. You should believe that Prabhupada is there. I can give example, one or two example. Purushottam Prabhu, he is a brahmachari. He is a brahmachari staying in Gopinath Gera. In Vrindavan, used to stay, not now. Purushottam Prabhu, staying there. At the time of leaving their body, they see Prabhupada coming. Many times. One or two examples I can see, I can give you. Raghav Chaitanya Prabhu, you heard the name? Raghav Chaitanya Prabhu and Purushottam Prabhu, they are two close friends. They are all South Indian origin. They are Brahmin. And so I need not speak Brahmin on this day because Vaishnava is more than Brahmin. But still I am speaking. They are so nice personality. They are the disciple of Prabhupada. Last time they took shelter there in one bhajan kutir. I used to stay many times there in Vrindavan. Gopinath Gera, Madhu Pandit, you know, Madhu Pandit Samadhi in Vrindavan, just near. They used to stay. They leave body one by one. When Raghav Prabhu leaving body, then somebody giving water to his lotus mouth. He looking here, sleeping and looking. Prabhu, what you are seeing? I see light all around, big light. He is going to leave body. He is lying in bed. Light? Yes. Now what you see? Now I see Prabhupada coming to bless me, take me. He's looking. And the man is just sitting beside. He cannot say anything. We can see. Prabhupada coming to take me. Now what you see? The Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, full troops. Gauranga Nityananda, they are coming. After that, giving water. Live body. This way, many examples I can say. One example I can see, I can show you. That in Assam, one couple, I mean husband and wife, they came to take, because they took kripa from Nimananda Prabhu first. Nimananda Prabhu. Because it's the standing instruction of Prabhupada on Nimananda Prabhu, you can allow Harinam to them. If you find they are okay, then you can bring them to me at the time of Gaur Purnim. They can do also circumbalance, I mean parikram of Gaurdham. At the same time, I can allow them Diksha. Not before that, if you think fit. So they took initiation from Prabhupada. After that, husband and wife gone. Long time they are doing bhajan. All on a sudden, we don't know the reason for why. The husband, he is due to bad association, he fall down. Due to bad association. Somehow, I don't know why. In Bhagavad, you can find who? Ajamilupakshan. If I explain Ajamilupakshan, this will take time. Big Siddhanta there. Paramahansa Siddhar Goswami used to speak. So, topmost Siddhanta, secret Siddhanta. Nobody can understand. Very, very topmost Siddhanta. There what happens, you know, that, I mean, husband, he live bhajan. Even not touching Harinam Mala. Even not touching. Taking wine, going here and there. Then wife crying. Oh my God, you got keep up from Prabhupada, now you leave everything. Hey, don't speak much. This way he is giving, threatening to wife. Then Prabhupada crying and praying unto the lotus feet of Prabhupada. Prabhupada, what to do? You have the responsibility to rescue him from hell. What I know? What I can do? I can do this much, Prabhupada. I can take the japamala of my husband and go and chanting in his name. That much I can do. Because he is not touching japamala. Shahadarmini. In Veda, in scripture, we say sahadarmini. I mean husband and wife, soul to soul unified. Then marriage is this word we can use. Marriage is nothing but unification of two different soul, maybe two different body. Unification of two soul. Same goal, unification of soul. No whimsical attitude. What husband can see, wife can see. One instant I can say, long ago, at least 14 years back, I am editing some book. Some books means, why I speak some books? Some books, not some book. 9 books published from Okhla in Delhi, industrial place. And they give me one small place in Chaitanyaguri in Delhi, Paharganj. I am sitting and very attentively editing. I mean, one by one, the pressman printing. And that pressman is also the disciple of Narayan Maharaj. Narayan Goswami Maharaj. So I have the chance, I am doing here, give me facility to stay there in top, there in press, there is facility there in, there for guests, they can stay nicely in nice room. This room. Oh, so nice arrangement, bathroom, everything, you can cook yours. I said, no, maybe some outside people coming. Use this oven and everything, I cannot stay here. Better I can stay in temple. Who can say what can happen? So I cannot stay here. So I am staying there. Now from France, one devotee, he already was there in Chaitanya Guru Mahat, Grihastha devotee. He was doing the association of, Bhaktivala Tithu Goswami Maharaj. He's sitting in front of my door. My attention is there, totally there, in paper. I cannot see. For a long time, I feel somebody standing there in door. I paid dandavat, he also paid dandavat. Then he started speaking something. For some possibility he was speaking that I am the disciple of Paramahansa Sridhar Goswami Maharaj. He's speaking like that. I can remember. Very nice, sober personality is speaking. After that I say, you are Grihastha. Yeah, I am Grihastha Maharaj. Then where is your wife? I put this question, where is your wife? He started crying, he bursted into tears. He bursted into tears, so much tearing. He cannot speak. I embrace him. Why you are crying? I put some sensitive question before you. Yes, Maharaj. My wife was so nice devotee that my room was like Golak. I used to invite so many devotees in my room. She used to cook, I used to cook together so much. But now I lose due to hepatitis B. I live this material world. We cannot keep her in this material world. So every moment I feel that she gone. She is devotee. So this way, husband and wife should be, there should be one and unique goal of Krishna Seva. Unification of two human souls. It is called actually marriage. Otherwise, marriage is nothing but marriage. Marriage, you know? You don't know? Hot time, you can see long in sand, there is water. It seems there is water. You run, there is no water. It is marriage. Not marriage. So don't go for marriage. At all, if you go, marriage properly. Be careful. This way, that wife crying to save husband, the husband going to threat her, then at the time of death, suddenly, because he is taking liquor, this, that, so health deteriorate, very gradually his health deteriorate, then after that, he is taking shit in bed, no more he can move, sick, husband, now, at least he cannot go outside to take wine, it's okay. By the blessing of Krishna. It's good. He cannot fight in anybody. Nice punishment. And by the time of death, Jamaraja sending some messenger, his servant to him to arrest him and come to Jamalai, one place of Jamaraja there. One place is there. Where is that place? South direction and west east direction and west direction. South and west corner. South direction and east direction. South direction and west direction. In middle, Ishan Kon. It is in Bengali called Ishan Kon. Ishan direction. If you go. Then very shortly you can meet Jamaraja, his kingdom. So Jamaraja sent the messenger, they came, very good, bad looking, a demonic character, they are coming to arrest him. They are pulling the shawl from his body. At the same time, he opened his eyes, and see that two Jamadutas are coming to arrest me. Like to arrest me and beat me. Then all on a sudden, he's shouting, Popa! Popa! Save me! I don't know why. Due to some past Sukriti, he's crying, Popa! Save me! Then all on a sudden, Prabhupad came. He's looking, Prabhupad already came. Prabhupad came and gave him protection. Yamaduta go back, they cannot do anything. Then he become, his sick lila gone, he sit and giving instruction to wife, hey, where is my japamala? Where is my japamala? Bring now. Then he started doing japamala up to last point of his life, he went out. This way, 100% I am sitting in Vyasasana, I am speaking the truth in front of you. You go on doing bhajan properly. False bhajan I cannot approve. I can leave my father also. I can throw my father if he is not in line. Be careful, I am so strong. So if you do actual bhajan, try to avoid asat siddhanta or asat sangha. Asat sangha, to eliminate asat sangha, to avoid asat sangha, what does it mean? Prabhupada speaking, to go for satsanga means, it means to eliminate asatsanga. If you go on doing satsanga and asatsanga simultaneously, then you are hypocrite. You are kapat. You cannot get result. In Vyasasana I am sitting, I am speaking the truth that Prabhupada like to give you full protection, provided you are sincere, 100% dedicated. That's all.
Gaurangoika gotir bhajasitamati si gaurodham astiti sassa saiga vitir kusanga virati dusto vetha niskriti si rupai karati sanatana nati si jivate jostuti si siddhanta saraswati vijayate gauriya goshtipati si siddhanta saraswati vijayate gauriya goshtipati
vancha kalpaturvashik basindh bhavacha patitanang pavane bhavishne bhyo namo. If you have any question, you can put in front of me.
Yes. You're saying if we do bhajan, then we have your approval. But I have heard that when one is still in the anatta nivritti stadium, it's not possible to do bhajan.
What? Anatta?
Yes.
Yes. Oh, you are speaking the same thing what I am speaking. Yes. Anatta, hear me what I say. That's why I told Ajamil Upakhan I wanted to explain, but I have no time. I can explain some time. Anartha is a very easy thing. Anartha can go away, provided you are doing satsanga. Anartha is not a big thing. Hear me. Anartha is not a big thing to give you, put you in trouble, provided you are going for satsanga properly. Adau sadhya tataho sadhusanga. After that, if you do sadhusanga, bhajan, sadhusanga, Krishna naam, ehi matra chai, saṃsār jinite ar kono vastu na. First of all, adau sadhya tato sadhusanga, tato bhajanakriya, atha anavathana vritti. Fear me, you need not play your head over this point. Only will have to concentrate, focus your mind on this point, that you are 100% doing sadhu-seva. I mean, satsanga. Then it's an automatic factor. We go on doing vajan and do satsanga. Then anartha going to fly. Yeah. Hear me what I say. So Krishna Bhagavan giving advice to Uddhava, it is not a big chapter. It is not a big topic to conquer Maya. It's very, very easy. This way you can conquer Maya. Many times I told you, you can remember the Siddhanta. Rajas tamas cha satyena satyam cha upasamena cha etat sarvam guru bhaktya puruso hi anjasajayat. Many times I told this Siddhanta. You can conquer very easily. Maya going to fear you. Maya going to fear you. Oh, I cannot touch. Provided you are doing satsanga. I can speak so many things after, if I get time. Today is up to that point. I'll have to, if you have any other question, you can speak.
They are not.
You see, this one secret point. Navadip bam parikrama, even one parikrama is more than sufficient to put you on nice planet. I mean, transcendental planet. But it cannot happen so. Why? Because our submission is not there. First of all, I can give example. Narottam Thakur is a realized, Gauranga Parshad. Srinivas Acharya is realized person. Huh? But how Jiva Goswami Pad realized? Jiva Goswami Pad is the personal associate of Radharani. Personal associate of Gauranga Mahaprabhu also. This Siddhanta is also secret Siddhanta. Why they come and do parikrama under the guidance of Nityananda Prabhu? Now speak it. This Leela exhibits the secrecy that you must do parikrama under the guidance of your Gurudev, I mean Shikha Guru, Dikha Guru. Otherwise, your parikrama is the mental satisfaction, nothing else. I mean, you can get some Sukriti, not more than that.
Yeah. So how to convince?
Very secret and sensitive question. If I go to answer this point, it will take weeks. Very secret question. I cannot speak so. You see, point is that this much I can say. Shikha Guru and Dikha Guru all the same in Chaitanya Bhagavad, Chaitanya Charitamrita is speaking. Now point is that still Dikha Guru has first preference because he give me Siddhanta Gyan. Though Prabhupada speaking, Dikha Guru and Shikha Guru all the same, because Dikha Guru giving me Diksha and Shiksha Guru Ovidya, I am getting knowledge about Ovidya, I mean starting bhajan. Maybe my Dikha Guru, Shikha Guru, same thing. In my life, my Harinam Dikha Guru, my Shikha Guru, my Dikha Guru, my base Guru, all same. Bhakti, I am lucky. All same. Bhakti Mahapurikasya. So what to do? I am lucky. So this way, you can choose one Shikha Guru. There is no doubt in it. Of course. But that Dikha Guru should be in 100% in line with my Dikha Guru. That Shikha Guru must be in line of my Dikha Guru. If I find some problem is there about my Guru Maharaj, he has no belief, no respect, then I cannot go to that Shikha Guru. Follow. Jiva Goswami Pad giving in Sandarbha so nice Siddhanta. So nice Siddhanta. So this much I can say, if you are sincere, then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave Nityananda Prabhu can give guidance inside your heart, give instruction, go there. He can act as your Shikha Guru. Don't go there. He can speak nice Harikatha, but he is not, he has no respect for your Guruji. So it is, you can, if you are sincere, automatically from in my heart also. Any people you bring in front of me, I can start Vandana, I can feel inside. Who is sitting in front of me? What is the position of their heart? Accordingly, I can speak Harikatha. It is not my credit. It is the credit of my Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Guru Maharaj. They give me instruction. Automatically, my tongue can start speaking like that, according to the degree of their elevation. So, you can do parikrama under the guidance of Shiksha Guru also, but it depends. Jiva Goswami Pad giving nice Siddhanta about it. Guru Bhag Gaya. Guru Bhag Gaya in Sandarbha, Jiva Goswami Pad giving this. I can explain this point someday. Now I can speak this slow. Guru Bhag Gaya. Guru Bhag Gaya. Tat Sevan Abhiradena Cha. Annesham Opi Vaishnavanam Pujanam Sevanam Sreya. Jiva Goswami giving this very secret Siddhanta. Guru Bhag Gaya, under the guidance, instruction of Guru Maharaj, Guru Bhag Gaya, Tat Sevan Abhiradena Cha. By the instruction of Guru Maharaj, I can serve other Vaishnavas, provided it is not hampering from my Guru Seva. You cannot understand with this brain what kind of Siddhanta I am speaking. Follow. Guru Bhag Gaya, by the instruction of Guru Maharaj, you can go and serve another Vaishnava, Shikha Guru. But it should not hamper your original Guru Seva. If your Guru Seva is undisturbed, then you can do. Tat Sevan Abhiradena Cha Annesham Api Vaishnavanam Sevanam Sreya. It is good. You can get power. Provided, there's two conditions. Many devotees used to come in front of my Guru Maharaj when Swami Maharaj gone, when even Swami Maharaj gone, when Paramahansa Sridhara Goswami Maharaj gone, when Gaur Govinda Swami Maharaj gone. They are all coming and crying in front of Guru Maharaj. That's why they are crying? They are coming to my Guru Maharaj, they are speaking, my Guru Maharaj gone, we are not getting power. Guru Maharaj used to speak in, we don't allow them to come in, because old age, you see, devotee is there, Guru Maharaj cannot hear, I'm in middle, I can hear what Guru Maharaj is speaking, translate them, what they are speaking, I'm speaking to Guru Maharaj this way. So many times, Guru Maharaj used to say, my son, always Kripa is there, like rain coming, but your pot is not good. Always Kripa. I also speak the same Siddhanta. Mahaprasadam Kripa, Dhamma Kripa, Nama Kripa, Vaishnava Kripa, Shastra Kripa, all coming, pouring on me. But my pot is not good. That's why all gone Kripa. This way Guru Maharaj used to say. So you can do one parikrama, it is more than sufficient, provided with sadhu sangha, proper sadhu sangha. Where no desire inside, heart no desire. That kind of pure devotees. Jiva Goswami Pada doing parikram with?
Nityananda.
Srinivasa Acharya doing parikram with? Whom? You know what I said? Family member of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Huh? Who? One servant.
Ishan
Thakur. Don't forget. He was the servant of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, personal associate. He was the servant of Vishnupriya Devi. After Mahaprabhu gone, he was the only family member. He used to give protection to, it's a general thing. Vishnupriya Devi. So lucky. So this way, you can get full protection from my Guru Maharaj through me. You can get full protection from Prabhupada, Guru Varga, if you are sincere. If you are not sincere, don't give any, Tarka. Vancha Kalpatirvasi. I'm going actually. Now I have to go and offer to Prabhupada, this, that, so many seva. Any doubt? Any question? What question? Come to me, my mother. She is my two mother. Twin mother. So nice, doing bhajan so nicely.
Huh? No, because you said that at the time Prabhupada, there was a fire, not in the heart. But now it's like lost, like the beauty is
gone. Oh,
what is missing? How to get this fire?
That fire can never be extinguished. First point you hear. That fire enlightened by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in parampara, successive parampara, it has to be there. Nobody can extinguish. But inside the heart of one realized soul, maybe you can find all devotees there in the uniform of devotees. They have no fire inside their heart because they are not in line. But some devotee must be there. If you are sincere, Prabhupada can arrange, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu can arrange some devotees who have fire inside their heart. Because it is a system. Gurudev, when giving me diksha, then fire, he is enlightening the fire inside my heart. So I am growing. So never in future, nobody can extinguish this fire. Believe me this point. So with this strong belief, you go on doing bhajan. Believe my word. Then if you are sincere, you can feel some power coming to me. Automatic. It's an automatic power. Because Prabhupada already bless us. Bhakti Vinod Dara can never be extinguished. Somehow it should be there. It must be there. So with this belief, you go on wing, you can see. Okay?